A lot of people think about seafood and they think like the ocean and it's so far out there. But the reality is that a lot of the fisheries that we depend on for seafood actually grow up in inshore shallow estuarine habitat.
Hi, I'm Dalia, Emmy Award-winning journalist and cookbook author. Join me as I explore the intersection of food and sustainability and how we can all make more eco-conscious choices when we eat. Angela, what a perfect Florida day.
It's beautiful.
Now, you grew up in this area?
I did, yes.
What was it like as a kid compared to now?
Oh my gosh, you know, really, Cortez is one of those places that hasn't changed very much over the past forever, honestly. There's really no place left like this in Florida.
It's definitely old Florida. You would never know this was here, and it's like perfectly preserved, which is so cool. But so much else in our world has changed. Absolutely. A lot of how we eat has changed. What do you think about when you're looking for seafood?
You know, if it's managed in the United States, you can be fairly confident that it's a well-managed fishery. We do a pretty good job here in the U.S. keeping tabs on all of the different species that are harvested. So if it's caught locally, if it's harvested in the U.S., I usually feel pretty confident that I'm making a sustainable choice.
Now, how would we even know that?
Well, you can look for the labels, you know, and if the labels aren't on the seafood invisible, you can ask where you're buying, where the seafood came from. I will say that a lot of the seafood that's available to the consumers in this country is imported. So it is sometimes difficult to find non-imported seafood. You know, using all of your senses to assess the seafood is a good, you know, look at it. Does it look good? Does it smell good? Is the texture good? All of those things are good ways to figure out whether or not you have a good product. Not knowing where your seafood product come from, I think there are risks inherent in that, and sometimes things can come from a place far, far away where potentially there are environmental issues involved with the harvesting or the growth of that product. And this isn't just seafood, this is anything that you consume.
Agriculture and tourism are two of our biggest economic drivers here in Florida.
That's right.
So the health of our waterways is important for so many reasons.
Oh my goodness.
What are some of the biggest threats?
The health of our bays, the health of our estuaries is absolutely critical to the survival of a lot of these species that we end up harvesting out in the ocean eventually when they grow up, right? So one of the biggest threats that I think that we see in Florida is just simply the number of people and the continued increased coastal development.
It feels like such a big task to take care of all of this. And I'm just one person. What can I as an individual do to help steward this beautiful gift that we've been given here in Florida?
We all have the power to make a little bit of change, and then when you put us together, we can make a lot of change. On the seafood side of things, I think supporting your local commercial fishermen. Sometimes you might pay a little bit higher price, but it's worth it. You have a local product, you're supporting the community that you live in.
And it's just a better product because it's fresh.
Yeah.
We know where it came from.
It didn't have to fly here on a plane.